Allison. This is a medication that you're going to be giving to your patient.
Alexa had to get the medication from the Pyxis and also judge it from the doctor's order.
Okay.
I take it out of the Pyxis. I'd first look at the name, make sure it's the same.
Okay.
I'd also have to be looking for expiration date and make sure this is the right dosage. And then I take it away from Pyxis and do a nebula check.
Okay, so can you tell me what the dosage is for that?
This is acetaminophen, and it says they're 500 milligrams each.
And what's the expiration date?
11/14.
Okay, good. Give me just a second, then I'll be alright. Okay, Allison, so we're going to be giving your first injection to Mr. Smith. Now, can you tell me what that medication is that you're going to give?
This is long-acting insulin. He's a diabetic.
Okay, and what are certain things that you need to do before you give this medication to him?
I need to check the doctor's order, get it out of the Pyxis, gather all my supplies, check the patient at the bedside, prepare the medication, and then I'm going to give this medication IV push.
I'm sorry?
IV push. I read it in the book last night.
Are you serious?
Yes.
Allison, you don't give long-acting insulin IV push.
It said it in the book, though.
No. No.
I checked the book. It did say I could, and it says...
It's never done in hospitals, no. You don't do that. Are you really sure you studied this?
Yes, and this is how I was going to prepare it for him.
Well, it's wrong, I'm sorry, but I don't think you can give this medication for him.
I can't
You're not prepared.
But right now we need to give you your heart medication.
Why can't I get my pain med?
Because the time is now for your heart med.
I want my pain med.
I understand that and I will go get them. But I need to give you your heart medication first.
No, I want my pain med.
And you said rise above.
Report. He's starting. The nurse before me gave me a few patients, and I really need to prioritize them first before I go see them. All right, the first one here is a 2-day stable angina. He's urgent. I really should see him, but I want to look at the other two before I rush into things. There's a 4-hour fresh post-op from abdominal surgery. I really should check on his drainage, and he is at high risk for bleeding. So he's really emergent. All right, there's a 5-day stomach virus. They're still waiting on the cultures to see if the antibiotics worked. He's a non-emergent. He'd probably be the last patient I would see out of these three. The first I would see is the 4-hour fresh post-op. Check his bleeding, check his drainage. The emergent one is a stable angina. 2-day, you have to check his heart rate and make sure he's not experiencing any chest pain. And the 5-day stomach virus, just to make sure he's comfortable and there's no new infection going on. All right, I feel confident, organized, and now I am going to go see my patients.
Know that I'll be waiting, standing on the precipice, I can soar away from.
Hi, Ms. Principe. I'm Allison, I'm your nurse from before, remember?
Mm-hmm.
I need to talk to you about some discharge planning, okay?
All right.
All right, can I have a seat and talk to you?
No problem.
All right. All right, we need to talk about your smoking history, okay?
Okay.
All right, I know some doctors have come in and talked to you about quitting completely. I'd like to come up with some plans and solutions for you, okay?
All right.
All right, I see you've been smoking since you were 10?
Yep.
Okay. Have you tried to quit before?
Never planned on it.
We'll increase your risk for lung cancer. So, let's make a plan. And then we'll see how you feel. If you're still comfortable with it, we'll continue it. If you're not, we'll go back to square one.
All right.
Okay. Right. I'm going to get some papers, some material, and then we'll go from there.
Your heart medication.
Your heart won't work anymore.
Out and about, it's such a crime.